You and I are involved in Movement Day, all right? So we should probably spend 30 seconds on that while we're together. You far more than me. I've only kind of blown in the last couple of years. But can you give these guys the skinny, the 30 seconds, because I know you're short of time, on Movement Day, what it is, and what we're hoping to achieve to business people?
Yes, so 8th and 9th of May, I believe. I hope those dates are right.
They
Movement
are.
Day is a gathering down in Sydney, and it's literally just a gathering of people that are understanding that there's a movement of God that is happening right across our nation, but in fact the world, where He is calling us to a greater level of intentional service to Him, but also to each other. So it's the body of Christ being called to a much higher level of influence and much higher level of impact for the kingdom. And there are so many stories getting out there of people that are out there on the front line seeing amazing things happen. And we are involved in the business side of things, and it's great that Wes is coming down to that this year to share. He's always got great input that he can bring into it, because I believe that the pastors have really caught this vision, and they're out there and doing great things in cities in terms of unifying and creating a movement for the kingdom and a unified movement. But business people, we tend to be lone rangers. We kind of have a nice time once a year at Wes's Kingdom Summit, but we're not normally rubbing shoulders and having a strategic approach like we really should be. And the hope is that we can come along and be encouraged, be inspired, and also be strategic about our place that we have in our nation as Christians in business to heal our cities and our towns in this nation. So it's quite an exciting thing, and something that we're very committed to and believe that it's got there's a real significance at this time and in this day that we're facing. So thanks, Wes, for the opportunity to plug Movement Day, because I think it's a great cause. Well, it's not even a cause, it's a movement.
It's a
group of people that know that God's speaking, and just talking about what that looks like.
I mean, and for me personally, I don't get involved in anything. I literally say no to everything, right? Because what we've got is too much, right? So, but when, you know, Movement Day 2 years ago, I came and you know, it's headed up by your pastor, who you've been had for, you know, a long, long time. And he's an amazing guy, Ian Shelton. But for me, it's probably one of the top three strategic initiatives in terms of changing culture in Australia. It would be by far, like getting transformation and change at a city level is genius. Because it just becomes this massive network of people relying on each other, war stories. And Australia is missing out on a blessing from God because we don't have unity, right? We've got politicians running around doing their thing, business people doing their thing, pastors doing their thing, and very little to bring us together. And so, like, you know, the word you've used before is silos. We've run around as silos independently, and we have to learn to work together to create change at a city level. And, you know, we just need to show people what that looks like. And at a city level, that is manageable. And that's essentially Movement Day. What's the URL? Do you know the URL that that people could go and check out Movement Day?
No, but I would Google Movement Day Australia.
Yeah. Craig, if you could,
because
just,
it's all over the world.
Yeah. So Craig's going to research it and put it into the comments, put a URL there for people, I don't know, go check it out, whatever. I'm actually going to be doing a formal invite to my business friends to say, hey, listen, join me in Sydney. Right. And let's see what the business community can do when it rubs against the politicians and the pastors and the stakeholders across the town.